ask that you speak to us on the throne of grace tonight. Bless us, ye Lord, scourge us, lift us up, elevate us, change our situation, change our story, release miracles to those who need it, in the name of Jesus, and let your name alone be glorified. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Put those before us tonight. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm just going to be speaking very briefly tonight on something I titled Toothless Lion. Just tap somebody. Tap somebody beside you to the right and to the left. To the left. To the right and to the left. Tell the person the devil is a toothless lion. Even if the person did not believe you, can you just walk to seven persons? Those who will believe you. Announce to them. Hallelujah. Praise God. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8 to 9. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8 to 9. Toothless lion. The devil is a toothless lion. He behaves like a lion, but yet he's not a lion. But his own likeness as lion has no teeth. Praise God. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. The assignment of Satan is to move from pillar to post, looking for the people, the kind of people that he can devour. So the devil cannot devour all men. The devil can only devour some certain set of men. If you are vulnerable, you will not be vulnerable to the devil.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. He said, no. Just go with me. Go back to verse 8. He said, be sober. What does it mean to be sober? Be sober means to be self-controlled. That scripture is saying, be self-controlled. Because if you are not self-controlled, there is he that moveth about like a lion, looking for those who are not self-controlled, that he can devour. Be sober. Simply means be self-controlled. Control yourself. Be disciplined. Because if you are not self-controlled, if you are not disciplined, you are vulnerable as a child of God. So many children of God today have been eaten up by the devil because they have no self-control. Be sober. Be self-controlled. Be disciplined. Immediately you give your life to Jesus, you have been immune against satanic attack. As soon as you give your life to Jesus, you have been immune against satanic attack. Not that satanic attack will not come, but you have been immune against it. It's just like naturally, we all have our own immune system. When sickness comes, the immune system will fight them on your behalf. You don't even know what goes on in your body, but yet when there's an attack on your body, on your health, on your body system, there is a power that fights on your behalf that makes the sickness want to break you down. So the same way that we have an immune system that fights for us, that makes sicknesses not to break our body down. The same way when you give your life to Jesus, you have been immune against satanic attack. So when Satan attacks you, he does not have power over you. When he roars against you, he has no power to hit you up. Why? Because you are born again. Redemption guarantees you immune system. It guarantees you immune power. But you need to be self-controlled. He said, be vigilant. What does it mean to be vigilant? It means to be alert. He said, be alert. The Bible says, watch and pray. You know what it means? It's not when you are praying, watch and pray. I love to close my eyes in love when I pray. But when we came into ministry, I discovered that it's not always necessary to close your eyes. He said, watch and pray. Amen. One day I was praying for somebody and my eyes were closed. But as I was praying, until the Holy Ghost said, open your eyes. So the person I was praying for was already manifested. I don't know who the person is. Until I opened my eyes and began to see something. Amen. Then the Bible, I now remember that scripture that said, watch and pray. Don't just pray. Watch there means be alert. When you pray, don't just pray. Pray and be alert. Be sensitive. Be sensitive. Even as you pray. Be alert even as you pray. Be vigilant. Because the devil moves around looking for whom to devour. Many people agree to Satan. Not because Satan has so much power, but because they are not vigilant enough. Because they are not alert enough. Amen. Amen. You know those people they call vigilante? If they sleep 1 second, they sleeping for that 1 second can cause them trouble. The enemy can inflict the territory as a result of them sleeping for 1 second. For 1 second. Amen. So, as a Christian, you need to be alert. Even when you are sleeping, be alert. When you are sleeping, be alert. He said, because you are adversary, the devil, you are not fighting too many enemies. You are fighting an enemy. You are not fighting too many enemies. You are fighting an enemy, the devil. And he walks about looking for those whom he may devour. As soon as you give your life to Jesus, you have an enemy. There is a battle line that is drawn. One thing you must know, many Christians are too insensitive. They believe that when you just give your life to Jesus, that is the end of it all. They say, I'm born again. Everything is to happen. I'm born again to reign again. Yes, you are born again to reign again. Are you ready? I'm born again not to suffer again. Yes, that is true. But are you not suffering again? I'm born again to prosper. Yes, that is true. That's what the scripture says. But are you prospering? I want us to answer ourselves some questions. Are you truly prospering? Are you a reflection of the scripture? Are you a reflection of what God has spoken concerning you? If you are not a true reflection, there is something that is wrong somewhere. Maybe you are not sober. Maybe you are not vigilant. Maybe there is an aspect of your life that you need to be self-controlled. Maybe there is an aspect of your life that you need to be alert. If you are not alert in those areas, some certain things will be happening in your life that will be against what the Lord has spoken concerning you in the scripture. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Give me the next verse. Resisting. You see that? Then if everything is just so simple as you give your life to Jesus, God will not say resisting. He said, resist him. see Satan. If you give your life to Jesus, you are entering into more trouble. Resist Satan of poverty. Resist Satan of stagnation. Resist Satan that will not let you move forward. Whatever that will stop you from becoming what God has ordained for you, resist it. Steadfast in faith, let your faith not be wavering. Whatever the word of God says is what it has spoken, and it will come to pass. Only you need to exercise your faith. Knowing that the same sufferings are experienced by your brotherhood in the world. Amen. Praise God. There are three major purposes that Satan has. Let me quickly show it to you. Satan is a toothless lion. If you are in the midst of lion and they have removed the teeth of the lion, there's nothing the lion can do, no matter how you are. The only worst thing will do to you now is to be roaring. So it's roaring without teeth is waste of energy. You even slap it. Fight, child! Even with his roaring, he has no choice because he has no power to defeat you anymore. His power lies in his teeth. But the teeth is no more. When Daniel was put in the den of lion, you know what happened? God removed, render his teeth powerless. The teeth of Satan is powerless already. The only thing he has is to roar. Though his roaring might be very terrible, might be terrifying, but yet it's powerless. Sometimes you see yourself going through some certain stuff, they are not actually real. It's just a rally of the devil. There are three major assignments that the devil has in this world. Let me please share it. No matter whatever the devil wants to do to you, there are just three major assignments he has. Let me please share it to you. John chapter 10, verse 10. John chapter 10, verse 10. John chapter 10, verse 10. If you understand the ministry of the devil and you understand your own ministry, you know that you are more powerful than the devil. Three ministries that the devil has. He said the thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. So three major things that the Satan has come to do on earth. Number one is to steal. He came to steal your job. He came to steal your promotion. He came to steal your blessings. Even though you have all of these, he has actually stolen some. That's why it appears that you don't have it. That you don't have it does not mean that you don't have it. That you don't have it manifested physically does not mean that you don't have it. It's existing in the realm of the spirit, but there is a power that has arrested it in the realm of the spirit. You know, in the book of Daniel, the Bible says Daniel was praying. He entered into 21 days fasting and prayer. And as he was praying, the Bible says the very first day that he prayed, God has granted him his heart desire. God has sent an angel to go deliver for him all the packet that he desired. But while the angel of the Lord was going to deliver the packet in the realm of the heavens, Prince of Persia arrested the angel. That's why we need to resist him. Any devil that wants to toy with your life on this altar of God, I resist it for you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. The Bible says that the demons oppose that angel that was to go and deliver. Demon, Prince of Persia. Daniel had to continue to resist. Daniel had to continue to persist. Daniel had to continue to pray. Until God saw that Daniel had not received that which he sent to him. Now, the fact that Daniel did not receive that package does not mean that the package is not for Daniel. The fact that Daniel has not received the package does not mean that the package is not meant for Daniel. The fact that Daniel has not received the package does not mean that the package is not released from God for him But because someone somewhere has opposed the power that needs to bring it to manifestation, that you are not a reflection of what scripture has spoken, does not mean that you are not truly a reflection of it. It is just because it has not been made manifested. Peradventure, there is a power that has been working against it, which you need to resist. Some demonic influence. So certain things will not happen if there are demonic influence. The Bible says, Joshua the high priest, the angel of the Lord went to bless him. But yet the angel of the Lord could not bless him. Why? Because Satan was beside him. And they clothed him with a filthy garment. So the angel of the Lord was incapacitated to release to Joshua what God has ordained for Joshua. Even though he was a high priest, but because of demonic influence, he could not receive that which the Lord had for him. Every demonic influence that has denied you of your right in Christ Jesus, today I resist them on your behalf. In the name of Jesus. The devil is a toothless liar. When I recognize this one, you can't dare me. I was telling somebody that ever since I've been in ministry, and you know, God used me in the area of deliverance sometimes, I don't have not really faced issue of devil coming to attack me. Because I know some things that I settled with God before I came into the ministry. But sometimes when we were in the garden there, when we built our church in the garden, there's something happened. Two ladies were there that God used me to cast out some satanic power, spirit, out of their lives. It was in a vigil. Maybe some of you can remember. And then I went home that morning and I slept. And I saw myself in the middle of, in a building, in a land. It's a landed area, but first round. But I was in the middle of that land. The fence was so tall. But I saw that I was surrounded by snakes. I was surrounded by pythons. I was the only human being there. And they were coming towards me to attack me. I said, the devil is a toothless lion. Yeah. Hey, these people are not hearing what I'm saying. I said, the devil is a toothless lion. Yeah. It can't do you nothing. It's just running. That's the best it can achieve. Just to run. Amen. So, as they were coming nearer, somehow, something took me up. I flew up, and the fence was so tall. As I was coming down, I came down on top of the fence. As I was landing on the fence, this very mighty big python was coming straight to my neck side. And when he was about to strike me on my neck, I discovered that something just wrapped me up on the neck. I don't know where that thing came from. An invisible hand of God just wrapped that thing on my neck and started to strike the plastic that was used to wrap my neck. Amen. Praise God. Redemption secures you. Redemption delivers you. Even though I was sleeping, I could not be attacked because I was too secure to be attacked. The devil is a toothless lion. You are too secure to be attacked. I say you are too secure to be attacked because the devil is a toothless lion. Anytime you see the devil harass you, tell the devil, my pastor says you are a toothless lion. You can do me nothing. Amen. Praise God. If the devil of sickness, how many of you know that sickness is devil? Poverty is a devil. They are all spirits of the devil. Suffering is a devil. captivity is a devil. Imprisonment is a devil. When they hear you, tell them you are a toothless lion. I am too secure. I am too defended to be a victim. Hallelujah. Amen. Are you going with me? Now, to steal, to kill, is looking for whom to kill and to destroy. But there's one thing, give me that scripture back. He said, I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. So Jesus came in order for us to have life. Jesus came in order to render your devil, the devil that is tormenting you, to render him powerless, to render his truth toothless. If somebody will be here, I don't care wherever the devil has been harassing you before now. I speak by the authority of heaven. Tonight marks an end to that plague of satanic harassment over your life. I say every satanic harassment over your life, tonight marks an end to it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because Jesus has defeated the devil. Give me Hebrews chapter 2, verse 14 and 15. Jesus has defeated the devil 2,000 years ago. The devil is already a defeated force. How can somebody who is already defeated come and defeat you again? It's an error. Inasmuch then as the children are partaking of flesh and blood, which is what we want to do tonight. We are partaking of flesh and blood. He himself likewise shared in the sin that through death he might destroy him who had the power of death, that is the devil. He might destroy him who had the power of death, that is the devil. So the power of death over your life has been destroyed. Yeah. Some of you have the insecurity of life. You always have fear of death. It looks like you are going to die. I speak to you, you are not going to die. Yeah. Because he who have the power of death has been destroyed already. And the key of death has been taken away from him. So he can't kill you before your time. Any devil that harass you with the fear of death, they will die for your sake in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Give me the next verse. 15. And release those who through fear of death, you see that, were all their lifetime subject to bondage. You are in bondage if you are still finding yourself having fear of death. Because death cannot give me what is there. I have Jesus, and Jesus is life and resurrection. He said to Martha, he said, because Martha said, if you had been here before my brother wouldn't have died. And he said to Martha, he said, your brother will not die, he will rise up again. And Martha said, I know he will rise up again in the resurrection day. She was looking at the particular day of resurrection. And Jesus said, don't think, I say to you, your brother will rise up again. I am the resurrection and the life. If you have it, Christ in you, the hope of glory. Colossians chapter 1, verse 27. Christ in you, the hope of glory. You partake of flesh and blood tonight, every devil tormenting you, they will go for you. Yeah. I said they will go for you. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. The devil is a toothless liar. That's why people like us, we can talk. We can attack the devil. I always tell you people, the best way of defense is attack. I told you that I was going to do number, I think it's number 3 in America, they call it. Is it number 2? I wanted to go and do number 2. And you know, in the village, the way to do number 2 in the village is you go to the bush. will go to the bush. You have to find your way to the bush. As I was on my way to the bush, I don't know where this old woman came from. The old woman just appeared before me. It was around 8 p.m., very late in night. I began to talk to her. But when I was listening to her, and I was talking to her as well, but suddenly, I realized that my number two is about to drop. Do you understand what number two means?
Yes, sir.
Some people didn't understand. I wanted to go and cook. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Is somebody excited here in the house?
Sure.
I just love this Jesus. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves him me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Me.
When the something was about to drop, and it would be too embarrassing for something to drop in the body of an adult like me, and this woman was opposing me, and it's a narrow road, narrow footpath. I raised up my hand and said, in the name of Jesus. I didn't say more than that. That name is powerful.
The name of Jesus is greater than
trying to wake me up.
to wake me up. Try to wake me up. See, leave me alone. I'm tired. Whatever it is, let in the morning we'll talk about it. I slept again. Ah, suddenly, she grabbed me again. Wake up, wake up, wake up. I had a nightmare, this and that. I said, kill the devil. Let me sleep. And I keep sleeping. Then she kept disturbing me. When the disturbance was too much, it was obvious that this one will not let me sleep. So I woke up. I said, okay, now what do you want me to do? He said, this devil is tormenting me. I said, okay, no problem. We started praying. I took my Bible. She took her Bible. We went into the still room. We started praying out. When she thought I was going to stop, I wasn't stopping. Everybody, both of us, we were sweating. Pray. You know, God endowed me with grace to pray. Praying. We both sweating. She was already feeling that we should go asleep. I said, you mean you are the one who requested that we pray? Let's pray. But after I finished the prayer, I said, there is no devil anywhere. As far as you're a child of God, no devil has the capacity in this. I said, do you want me to prove it to you? She said, yes, I should prove it to her. I said, okay, watch. I said, you devil, wherever you are now, I challenge you. Come out. Let's face it, battle for battle. If you win me, no problem. You can even take my wife. If I win you, yes, leave my wife alone forever. The devil did not appear. We waited for the devil to appear for 5 minutes. The devil didn't appear. I told Boaji, you see that he's a toothless lion. He cannot appear because he knows that he's already defeated. He's a defeated force. He's just running, and that's the best that he can do. Is somebody with me in this house? Some of you that think that the devil, every now and then you are. If I have never been fortunate to dream of nightmare, not once, I've never been fortunate. I don't know whether it will happen tomorrow. I'm not saying it shouldn't happen. The day it happens, you know what I will do? Because actor know they die. Have you ever watched a film where actor dies? How many of you watch this? You know, some of you here are too small. Yeah, you may not know this film. How many of you watch Scarface? Scarface. You mean you watch Scarface when you were growing old? Because Scarface was an old, interesting film that we watched in those days. Now, what happened in that Scarface was that the last part of that Scarface, they shoot the actor, and the actor enter into the swimming pool. It looks like they come everywhere, all over his body, blood everywhere. It looks like he's dead. I said, this man was not dead because he's the actor in this film. It means that this Scarface must have part two. Because in a film, actor know they die. Now, in the film of life, you are an actor. Is somebody with me here? In the film of life, I said you are an actor. So you cannot die. Until the film ends, you cannot die. No matter how powerful the boss is, the boss shall die. So if I mistakenly dream a nightmare dream, when I wake up, I will not pray. Some of you will probably pray. Which prayer? That's not the time to pray. That's the time to conquer. The time to conquer is different from the time to pray. There's time for everything. The Bible says, in life, I heard from him and says, sin can still do what? It can still bite you with his toothlessness. Praise God. I said, praise God. Hallelujah. Number three, Satan uses the tactics of inaction to get the children of God. Many times we are procrastinators. It's a tool in the hands of the devil. In fact, I'll make it four tactics of Satan. I'll add one more to it because the Holy Spirit is saying that to me here because of somebody.
Hallelujah.
The tactics of miracle. So many of us, we have read, we know so much about the word of God, but we are very inactive. We can't exercise our faith on what we know.
You know that God is a miracle working God, but yet you need miracle, you are still doubting in your spirit, man. You are saying, if God likes, let him do it. If God doesn't like, let him do it. Who told you?
Someone came to Jesus. He said, if you will, heal me. Jesus said, I will. I always come to you. Be healed.
Hallelujah.
He said, be healed. I am much eager than you to heal you.
Our inaction of obeying God's word, our inaction of exercising our faith in God's word, sometimes as against the fiery darts of the enemy, is what makes the devil to defeat us. Even though he's already defeated. Tap yourself, I refuse to be inactive again.
Exercise your faith! Intimidate Satan
with the word.
Intimidate him with what you know. Tell him, I can never be sick.
If one sickness is killing you, even though the sickness is inside your body and it's killing you, and your doctor has said this is a terminal disease, just get said, you are going to die in 12 days.
Tell the doctor, that is your report. That's not God's report. God said, I will not die, but live to declare the counsel of the Lord, and I chose to believe what God says about me. And you begin to exercise yourself about what God says about you. It doesn't matter what you feel. It doesn't matter the circumstances. It doesn't matter the situation. It cannot be greater and bigger than the word of God. Don't be inactive in what God has spoken concerning you. You are not a poor man.
When I say I can never be poor, people think that I have so much money in my account. Being wealthy is not the amount of millions that's in your account. You can have millions in your account and be very poor.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you might not have money in your account, you just know who you are in Christ Jesus. I just know that I'm a billionaire. I just know that it's impossible for me to be poor. I just know that it's impossible for me to be oppressed by the devil. I just know that it's impossible for me to be sick. And that's why it is impossible indeed for me to be poor.
I just know it's impossible for me to beg. And it's working. I am activating it. I am activating it. Even though I am not there yet physically. Yes, I'm activating it. Because very shortly, I am going to be there. I am under construction. This is what the Lord said about me. And so shall it be in my life. Don't let the devil deceive you. Be active. Be active in the word of God. Be active. Be active in the knowledge of the word of God. Be active. They that do know their God, they shall be stronger and they shall do exploit.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Number four. Number one, intimidation. Number two, ignorance. Number three, inaction. Number four, discouragement. Discouragement is a satanic tool. Discouragement is a satanic tool. Let me tell you something. The devil will bring discouragement into your life to make you sad, to make you sorrowful. That was exactly what happened to this lady I was looking for. I was looking for the fruit of the womb in the Bible, in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 1. Anna. She was discouraged. She was discouraged about everything. And she kept going to Shiloh. Nothing happened in her life. The Bible says when Samuel was given to her, it was when she went to Shiloh and she communed with God. And the Bible says after she communed with God, her countenance was no longer sad. In other words, when your countenance is sad, you cannot receive anything from God. And Satan know that if you are sad and discouraged, you cannot receive nothing from God. So it will bring sadness.
It will bring discouragement so that you can access heaven.
And that's what he does to so many of you. I've not gotten this job for so many years. I've been healed. I've been sick. I've not been healed for so many years. I cannot continue like this. Is there God at all? Is God, has God forgotten me? Oh. God has not forgotten you. Just stay focused on the word. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2. It says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finishers of our faith.
Discouragement.
So many people get so discouraged very easily. That's why the Bible says in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 10. It says, murmur you not. He said, because if you murmur, I'm going to deliver you to a destroyer to destroy you. Don't let God give room for the destroyer, the devil, to destroy you. That's the tactics of Satan. It's the tactics of what? Of Satan. If there's any situation in your life, search through the world and look for the word of truth that will conquer that very situation of your life. I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be good health, even as thy soul prosper. He himself bore our infirmity. Many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord God delivered them all. Praise God. Search for the splinter of truth that will defeat the situation of your life.
I love Jesus. I love Jesus. I love Jesus. He's my friend. He's my friend. I will never leave him. I will never leave him. He's my friend.
Jesus is awesome. Don't permit discouragement in your life. Do you know if you are discouraged, you'll be depressed? If you are depressed, you'll be oppressed. You cannot be oppressed unless you are depressed. And you cannot be depressed unless you are discouraged. So discouragement brings about depression, and depression brings about oppression. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? Many Christians are oppressed, even though, as a born-again child of God, you are not supposed to be oppressed. But discouragement sets in. Don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged over your pastor. Don't be discouraged over your friends. Don't be discouraged over your colleagues. Don't be discouraged over your boss. Don't be discouraged over God. Don't be discouraged over nothing. If anybody hurts you, move on. Dust your body and move on. Forgive and move on. Always give excuses not to be discouraged. Always encourage yourself in the Lord. You know what happened in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 30? David was returning from a war front. From Sidla, and the Bible says they had already conquered. He helped his men, his kinsmen, and they returned. And as they returned, they discovered that they have taken away captive their children and their wives and their properties. They have invaded the place and they have taken them captive. And so when they got there, the men that were with David, they were greatly distressed and they were so unhappy. And they even got so discouraged that they felt like they needed to stone David, who is helping them. They said, David would have left them alone to be with their wife. Let all these people even come and take all of us captive. But at the end of the day, what happened? They thought of stoning David. And the Bible says, and David was greatly discouraged. David was greatly discouraged. Everything that has to do with discouragement will always come to you at one time or the other. You are not immune against them coming. You cannot pray against them coming. They will always come. No matter your prayer, they will always come. But you can make up your mind that you will not be discouraged. When discouragement comes, drive it out. Resist it. When discouragement comes, resist it. Hallelujah.
And David resisted discouragement. And David said, the Bible says, David encouraged himself in the Lord. 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 And after he encouraged himself in the Lord was able to speak to him. And the Bible says, and David inquired. He said, should I pursue? And the Bible says, God said, pursue. He didn't stop there. He said, should I overtake? And God said, overtake. And at the end of the day, he said, should I recover all? God said, recover all.
Everything that has taken away captive, everything that belongs to you, both living and non-living, I command you to pursue, overtake, and possess it all back in the name of Jesus. I say, recover all in the name of Jesus. Don't be discouraged. It's a tool in the hands of Satan. Hallelujah. I say, praise God.
Hallelujah.
I say, praise God.
Hallelujah.
One major thing I want to mention to the five clubs. The master key that will paralyze the truth or the teaching of Satan is service. I want to repeat myself. The master key that will paralyze the teaching of Satan is what? Service. I have noticed that I have discovered it. It has worked for me. It's not prayer. It's not prayer. Prayer is very good. Prayer is good.
Resist the devil and he will flee.
But he can flee today and come back tomorrow. Then tomorrow, you keep resisting till you won't have any better to do other than to be resisting. What time do you have to be resisting the devil all the time? You resist it today, tomorrow it comes back. You resist it tomorrow, next tomorrow it comes back. You keep resisting. You will wear off yourself now, two of us. But God said, there is a provision for the children of God. As you give your life to Jesus, when you serve, the devil will naturally leave you alone. Let my people go so that they can serve me. So the only reason why Satan will lose you and set you free and forget about you is for you to serve. Exodus chapter 9 verse 1, let my people go so that they can serve me. Exodus chapter 4 verse 23, let my people go so that they can serve me. Why will God push the devil off your life? Because so that you can serve him. So if your service is intact, the devil, you will not be vulnerable to the devil. If your service is intact, you will not be vulnerable to the devil. If your service is intact, you will not be vulnerable to the devil. If your service is intact, you will not be vulnerable to the devil. Open this Bible, Exodus chapter 2. Let's look at the last scriptures, verse 8 and verse 12. Exodus 3, as I close. The master key that makes Satan powerless and toothless is service. Is service. If you are here, your service is not intact. Repent tonight. That's the only way out. It's the only guaranteed way out. Exodus chapter 3, verse 8. So I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptian. I have come down. I have come down. God Himself said, I have come down to deliver them from the hands of the Egyptian. I have come down to deliver it from the hands of Satan. And to bring them out from the land to a good and a land, to a land flowing with milk and honey, to the place of the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Ammonites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites. Give me verse 12. I saw your feet as you read this one. So he said, I will certainly be with you, and this shall be a sign to you that I have sent you. When you have brought me the people out of Egypt, you shall serve, you shall serve, you shall serve, you shall serve God on this mountain. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, when you have been saved from slavery, when you have been delivered from bondage, why are you delivered? So that you can serve me on this mountain. The only key to your total and absolute freedom is service. Lift up your hands and say, Father, I will serve you. You be God, you know me. You be God, you know me, my Lord. I follow my God.
Set free in the name of Jesus.
You can take it.